this is different. This room is unbelievably quiet. It's so nice to once actually have total control over the sound. Anyway, just appreciating that. How's it going? My name's Jojo, and thank you so much for taking a bit of your time to come on down to our channel. You know, as a pianist or aspiring musician, I think it's paramount to understand the history of your given instrument, and the piano is no exception to that. I've been wanting to make this video for a very long time, so if you are excited and maybe want to see something like this, consider giving this video a thumbs up. It would mean a lot to me. So tonight, we are going to be playing on one of the most ancient, most brilliant, classy, relaxing instruments in Western society, the clavichord. I was researching about the piano in a essay I had to do, and I figured why not play on the ancestor of the piano. So I went into this room, and the first time I played on the clavichord, I just instantly fell in love with it, and I had to make a video with it because it sounds perfect for ASMR. So we're gonna be making some music with it, very relaxing Bach that I've prepared for you guys. So I'm going to be playing a piece and then pausing for a second, showing the specs and moving around with the camera and show you the instrument, and it will kind of be me going back and forth from performing and talking about the instrument and whatever. So let's get started. I'll show you what we're going to be playing. So this right here is the first book of Johann Sebastian Bach's Prelude and Fugues. So if you don't know, Bach wrote 48 different preludes, or 24 preludes and fugues, each in a different key. So it's pretty crazy, and I'll get into that, but let's start with a tune. Thank you. guess I'll talk a bit about the instrument. So the clavichord is, I guess, the predecessor of the harpsichord. I'll have a few shots, you know, of the instrument and whatever, but so where to really begin? What do I know? I don't know that much, but what I do know from my little research is that, so the clavichord, back in the period of the kind of high Renaissance and early Baroque period, the clavichord was starting to see a lot of popularity by composers like J.S. Bach, obviously. We also had people like Handel, S.C.P.E. Bach, his son, and everything. But the clavichord is just a fantastic instrument because it provided its own accompaniment, and it was a solo instrument. It was fantastic. You had other composers like Elizabeth Jacquet, I think that's how you pronounce her last name, French composer, I think. I wrote many keyboard suites for the piano. Sorry, the clavichord, keyboarded instruments. But essentially, the harpsichord was just really expensive at the time, and the clavichord served as the kind of domesticated musician's harpsichord. So what you'll notice about the instrument is it's just very, very quiet, and it has very little range of dynamics. And that's the thing about the clavichord. You have these fretted clavichords where each key is sharing a pair of strings with other notes. So what you basically get is a very low volume of sound. And also, these strings aren't made of the same material as the modern piano. So, it was very difficult to kind of produce a loud sound with the clavichord. That's why it would be really good for practicing at home back in those times, which is why the clavichord was really easily accessible to a lot of people who were wanting to pick up music and to start their musical experience. But it was just really budget friendly, and it was really quiet, so you couldn't really use this in a ensemble setting. You could really only use this in performance with, in a very intimate audience of like few people in like a lounge. And a lot of music, piano or keyboard music, was intended that way, to be performed in front of a very small audience of a few people only. Never did the composers imagine, a lot of them, that their repertoire would be played for thousands of people in huge halls and stadiums, for example. So a lot of this music is kind of technical exercises. And on the clavichord, you can never really, as I said, perform for a big audience. And it was terrible for being used in, say, chamber music or operatic work, or symphonic work for that matter. That's why the harpsichord is much more oftenly used in those works, because then it can produce a louder, more fuller sound than the clavichord. But let's get into the next piece, and the next one we're going to be doing is, instead of C major, C sharp major. We'll do the prelude and then the fugue. So just to let you guys know what a prelude and fugue is for any of you laymen out there. So the prelude is a very shortish work that's quite simple, and it serves as kind of the entree into the meat and potatoes of the piece, which is the fugue. Okay, so the prelude is quite simple, has a very simple sense of counterpoint. It's usually two or three voices only. You'll hear in this one I'm about to play you, there's a motif going on, and there's a kind of conversation between two hands. But it's supposed to be an exercise, it's supposed to warm you up for the main course, which after this you'll hear the fugue. So what is a fugue? A sequences, and you'll hear a main motif, a main kind of melody or, you know, hook. You'll hear that hook played at the very beginning in one hand, and then that hook will then keep on reappearing throughout the piece. So when another voice enters, it will play the same hook, but it will play it four notes above or below. It's kind of complicated, but when you hear the fugue, you'll notice that the main melody is played first, and then again in the left hand straight after, and then again in the left hand a second time, but in a different register of the clavichord. So you'll have three different voices kind of duking it out, you know, creating their own harmonies, and it sounds really nice. So we'll get into that.
Thank you.
enjoyed that brilliant fugue. I'm having a lot of fun being here, I won't lie. It's so nice once in a while to just do something different. So I hope you guys like this video. But yeah, let me know if you want to see any more of these kind of weird performance video. Clavichord is just has such a different action compared to the piano. It's much more sensitive and much more delicate. So, we're just going to get into that. If you enjoyed this video, please feel free to show your support by giving this video a thumbs up and consider hitting that notification bell and subscribing. But with that said, thanks so much again for coming, and we will see you in the next video.